The worst situation for a pilot to be in is while he is in the weapon system to have some issue with the avionics that causes the radar to lose lock, the heads-up display to blink out, the onboard oxygen generating system to not function properly, to where he has to either abort the mission or back off from the flight profile to get those systems to come back to life.
TQS has looked at the problem in detail for many, many years. We got involved in this by looking specifically at the maintenance data and understanding the root causes why these line replaceable units that provide key functions to the aircraft as we're coming off the airplane. We found by tracing these LRUs by serial number that we could positively identify where there was a problem in the chassis that wasn't being addressed. The Intermittent Fault Detection Isolation System is a game changer, and very unique is its technology. Automatic test equipment in the depot tests functionally. It doesn't actually test every communication path within a chassis before it goes out. There can be a technician that spends hundreds of hours trying to find all the wiring in here that might be the source of one of those problems. But that could take months, hundreds of hours. Being able to do that within 15 minutes sometimes, or even if you run through the entire environmental profile, 2 or 3 hours to run through and find all the problems in here, get that chassis back on that airplane operational, and instead of coming off in 12 hours, it takes 900 hours before it comes off. That is huge for the warfighter from a capabilities perspective of readiness, supply chain, costs, O&M expenditures, and all the time that it takes to do everything in between. We stimulate this LRU based on temperature and also vibration. Using this shaker in this environmental chamber, we can induce operational environments that discover those intermittents that happen in flight that you can't test anywhere else. Within this LRU itself, 8,400 circuits that have to be checked. It's almost impossible to do that manually. The Intermittent Fault Detection and Isolation System provided by Universal Synaptics, our small business partner in Roy, Utah, now provides the capability to fill that critical gap. By returning LRUs to service and extending their time on wing, it saved the government tens of millions of dollars for just one LRU.
So the intermittent fault detection capability is delivered in two specific packages. You have the depot version or even an intermediate level version, which is the intermittent fault detection and isolation system that utilizes temperature and vibration to ring out the intermittents to get them to manifest themselves. The other package that it's deployed in is called the Voyager Intermittent Fault Detector, or VIFD. It's a deployable, hardened, hermetically sealed intermittent fault detector that can go to a forward operating base, it can go under wing, it can go on a carrier deck, so that we can get this capability that produces readiness closer to the warfighter. According to the GAO, the Department of Defense owns and maintains about $50 billion worth of test equipment. Yet the Department of Defense still has a massive readiness and availability issue. They also have a $2 billion annual no-fault found problem, which is astounding when you consider that the entire electronics maintenance budget is $20 billion. So we've got about a 10% problem there that can be solved. What makes this a game changer is that this $50 billion suite of test equipment is not solving this problem. It is not addressing this intermittent discontinuity problem that this tester addresses.
I have worked with IFDIS for many years, and I have seen the technology work well. I've seen it help the technicians on the floor. The frustration level goes down. It also helps when technicians have to train other technicians. We're not now looking for something that isn't there. An intermittent fault is like finding a ghost, so technicians really appreciate the system when we have a good chassis to work with. Now we just have to deal with the electronics, and it takes the chassis out of the equation.
The original Small Business Innovative Research Project that was funded by the Air Force, current flow through a UUT, began taking the idea of IFDIS and making something of it. We now have multiple Phase 3 Small Business Innovative Research projects underway, supporting the DoD by developing and delivering these IFDIS to those customers. TQS has been working Small Business Innovative Research programs for many years now. This IFDIS is one example of the ones that we've gotten all the way to Phase 3. The IFDIS is fielded in the Air Force and also in the Navy and is available to other DoD customers.
The Air Force SBIR program has been instrumental in bringing together all the key ingredients, be it projects, contracts, funding, to allow our company to expand, to grow, to bring on additional technical people, which those are well-paying jobs. I think it's been great for the community, I think it's been great for the state of Utah, and I think it's been great for the Air Force. Total Quality Systems has won a Tibbetts Award from the Small Business Administration. This technology's been highly recognized, highly decorated, well received, and awarded for the tremendous results that it produces. The people that work at Universal Synaptics and the people that work at Total Quality Systems recognize that we've got young men and women putting their life on the line in faraway, scary places. Their equipment better work. If you care about readiness, if you care about availability, if you care about the warfighter, you should care about this technology.